City volunteers reached out to the family of the taxi driver who died of COVID-19. Tzu works with a Catholic group to distribute supplies to families in India. Welcome to DaAi Headlines. I'm Siri Su. Thank you for joining us. The first death from COVID-19 in Taiwan was a private taxi driver in Changhua City. Some of his family members were also infected and discharged from the hospital after treatment. City volunteers visited a family who lost their source of income and assessed how to provide them with long-term assistance.
No one wants to be infected by the virus. The younger brother and mother of a private taxi driver in Changhua has been cured and discharged from the hospital. Although it's already a while, their inner fear still remains.
Frankly speaking, many people don't dare to come after they learned about our situation. That's normal. We won't complain about anything.
Tzu Chi volunteers got to know this 90-year-old senior when they visited other people. They felt sorry for the sudden death of her son.
Volunteers will come to keep grandma company regularly. Apart from this, if she needs our long-term financial assistance, we'll help her apply.
The private taxi driver's brother has lost his job for several months already. Besides worrying that he couldn't afford the rent and living expenses, he also worried no one takes care of his mother.
I hope I can take care of my mother while working, at least maintain basic life needs.
He said that he was applying for assistance and would try to be self-reliant later. In the meantime, the most important thing is to take good care of his mother.
Parts of the United States are returning to life as normal, but COVID-19 is still very visible on everyone's mind, such as in the state of Illinois. Chicago City volunteers take turns staffing the chapter, but still make sure medical supplies are donated to hospitals in need. To date, they have donated over 250,000 surgical masks to different medical facilities.
Very nice evening, okay?
Organizing the information on the computer of the hospital's needs, Chicago Tzu Chi volunteers are diligent in making sure they provide immediate assistance.
When I called your organization, I spoke with Amy and Chong, and they were so kind and said that they would be more than willing to help. They said, come immediately. So I'm here on a Saturday. We don't know how long this will go on, and we know that we're going to need to continue to protect our healthcare workers so they can continue to care for these patients. So we're extraordinarily grateful to this organization for the generosity and the responsiveness that they've showed us.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank okay. you. God bless you. God bless you.
Many of the healthcare workers come to pick up the medical supplies and also visit the Tzu Chi Chicago chapter.
It's a beautiful space out here, and I'm so happy to see it and to meet you guys, and the work that you're doing is really amazing, and we really, really appreciate your support and your donation and helping.
Yes.
And it's really great.
I think it's wonderful what you're doing, and I think more of us need to know about it, right? You know, because you're kind of in our backyard and we're not aware of, but obviously you're having a huge global impact, you know, so not just here in the US, but also around the world, and that's amazing.
Thank you so much.
Sincere care to help spread seeds of love, Tzu Chi is there on this long road to end the pandemic.
The pandemic has swept across the United States. Many people are unemployed, so their families have financial difficulties, and even their stomachs are not full. Volunteers host a food distribution drive-through. They also send epidemic prevention supplies to the hospitals.
The queue, of course, is so long that it cannot be seen at the end. Yet, no matter how long they need to wait, they are willing to be there since they can't bear it anymore.
They can't go to work and there's no way to live a normal life. Maybe they can't even pay the rent. Every time when they have an income, they'll take it off for daily expenses. Their most worried thing is that they don't know where to get the money to go buy food for their family.
Life is desperate, but at the moment when the truck is opened, the light of hope finally shines into every family.
We have prepared 350 food packages today. Our volunteers will put the fruits and Argentine products, including some instant rice and noodles, in their cars.
The distribution of food packages through drive-thru is carried out in many places of California.
There's six of us all together. I got three children and three adults. This food will help me because I don't have a job right now and it's needed.
Pandemic has affected me and my family, and I heard this from my little brother's school from a paper, and I feel really great about this because it's helping out many families.
Members of the public are fighting against economic pressure, while the medical personnel are fighting with lives. The medical supplies can provide a peace of mind for the medical staff.
Thank you! Thank you, Tzu Chi, for your jumpsuits, for your masks.
In Hong Kong, Tzu Chi and a well-known hotel chain work together to distribute 16,000 care packages to low-income families and solitary seniors for 8 consecutive months. Every piece of food and daily supplies is timely assistance for these people.
The rain outside was so heavy. The 11-year-old child, who is more mature than other kids of the same age, collected the supplies alone.
Because my mother needs to go out to work, we can cook those instant noodles when I and my brothers are hungry.
A volunteer from a hotel train group accompanied the little child to go home, which took them half an hour by walking.
My son is about the same age as him. I don't allow and also can't bear my son to be left alone. I think he is very independent and very brave to come.
Changhua Hong Kong chapter cooperated with a hotel chain to deliver care packages to the Hong Kong Family Welfare Society to help families affected by the epidemic.
This epidemic has severely affected society. Many people lost their jobs and hence their income has greatly reduced. So we especially help these families at this time.
Volunteers worried that the care packages are too heavy for me, so they kept me company while taking it back home. Thank you very much.
I want to join these activities more and help those seniors in need. This is the first time for me to join city volunteer work. I'm very happy.
During the epidemic, it is hoped that everyone can let go their loss while cherishing what we now have.
In Malaysia, city volunteers have cared for foreign workers who have lost their jobs due to the movement restriction order. On Eid al-Fitr, city volunteers made delicious dishes that tailored to their taste to celebrate the occasion with them. This table full of delicious Indonesian dishes are made by city volunteer Riyani and her family.
I heard from Sister Mainan that we should form good affinities with the Indonesian foreign workers and help them celebrate Eid al-Fitr.
Riyani, who's also overseas Chinese from Indonesia, has asked her family to help prepare food. Upon learning that community volunteers are helping Indonesian foreign workers celebrate Eid al-Fitr.
My children chopped up the vegetables and peeled the egg. They were happy to help. This is a good opportunity for my entire family to serve other people, forming good affinities.
Due to the epidemic, the work at the construction site has been suspended. As the workers worry about how to celebrate Eid al-Fitr, volunteers have brought them a surprise.
Thank you for your help. I don't have work or income. You have provided food for us. Thank you very much.
I have received your help before. Now I can celebrate Eid al-Fitr. I'm very happy.
We can obtain nutrients from vegetables and beans.
All the food is vegetarian and foreign workers enjoy them very much.
The food is delicious. When I ate the poutine, I was reminded of my family back home.
Dear friends, you can contribute however much money. We will take the money to help other people in need.
In Islamic teachings, followers are encouraged to make donations on Eid al-Fitr. The foreign workers made donations showing their compassion and love. With the help of overseas volunteers, City Foundation has been able to deliver epidemic prevention supplies to 67 countries, including India. In India, City volunteers have joined hands with a Catholic group to distribute aid supplies to more than 700 families in southern India. The cooperation has proven that love transcends religious differences. The way these impoverished teenagers and children are carrying supplies looks very familiar. They work in relays similar to city volunteers. Taiwan and India are 4,800 kilometers apart. Love transcends boundaries, religious differences, and ethnicities. Tzu Chi Foundation is working with the chameleons to distribute aid supplies to 703 families in four villages in southern India. Every family is given 20 to 22 kilograms of supplies. For women and children, they're given 16 and 10 kilograms of supplies and food vouchers to lessen their burdens. Putting more hearts into our hands is the goal of the chameleons. Founded in 1980, it has 50 organizations in 9 areas in India. Despite the suffering and plight of the local residents, these people have brought love and warmth to them. Bohol Island of the Philippines is still under lockdown, and local city volunteers purchased rice to help the poor in the area. They spent 2 days visiting 18 boroughs of San Miguel. This time, people receiving assistance are mostly the old, the frail, and the infirm. Those families received 25 kilograms of rice and were very grateful to Tzu Chi.
Imo Master Chingying daghan sa kajong salamat sa imong pagtabang namong mga PWD labi na dinhi sa barangay Kurason ug sa tibok. Lungsod sa San Miguel, daghan sa kajong salamat.
The truck filled with rice is making a dust storm as it travels the dirt road, but volunteers are still determined to make this trip because many of the residents in this remote area are starving.
Kung nasayran nga, dili man lang pang hatag o bugas, kung dili daghan mga.
In our region, the average income per family is probably the fourth in the country. We're considered one of the poorer counties. Many of the residents don't have enough money. They don't work during this time. The rice you give them will help a lot of the families out.
This is San Miguel of Philippines' Bohol Island, where the volunteers spent 2 days to distribute rice to 18 boroughs.
Thank you for giving rice to those in need. Thank you to those who volunteered. I have nothing but the best wishes for you, and I hope to see you serve more disabled people in need.
During the distribution, it seems the cycle of love continues as many people donate some change from their pockets, paying the love forward so more people in need may receive help.
To celebrate Children's Day, which falls on June 1st, Sichuan City volunteers work together with Huaikou Township government to hold activities for impoverished children. They also visited some children from underprivileged families to provide love and care.
Some children do not have the chance to celebrate Children's Day. This group of volunteers are here to remind them of the occasion. Since her parents are mentally challenged, 12-year-old Huang Haicheng is introvert and does not talk much. The volunteers can see how this family suffers from financial difficulties.
Compared to them, my child seems to have grown up in a very strict environment. If I am given a chance in the future, I hope to accompany these children with empathy.
Sichuan City volunteers and the Huaikou Township government are celebrating Children's Day for children of impoverished families. They lead the children to play games and read picture books. In addition, they go to the recycling station to learn about cherishing resources.
In the past, when we celebrated Children's Day at our school, we simply watched performance and ate snacks. Today, we get to do handicrafts and have a tour of the recycling station. I feel very happy today.
We also want to go to their families and see what other needs the families have. Then we will work together to accompany them.
The volunteers accompany and listen to the children, delivering their best wishes to these children.
Chen Yutong is an 11-year-old girl in Tainan. She's an only child and frequently accompanies herself by raising small pets. She once served as a volunteer at Jingzi Books and Cafe and made some good friends who were vegetarian. Soon she told her parents that she wanted to embrace vegetarianism. She has been a vegetarian for 3 years. She finds that this diet keeps her strong.
In order to get a vegetarian lunch, Chen Yutong has to cross the playground and walk 100 meters away. There are a total of 3 classmates who are vegetarians just like her. Their school vegetarian meals are often eye-catching.
I found out my school has a nutritious vegetarian lunch, and I was so happy that I ran to my teacher and said that in the future I want to be a vegetarian.
Yutong's father was previously the only member of the family who was vegetarian. He was surprised to see his daughter become a vegetarian.
When she was a child, I didn't insist she becoming vegetarian. I just let her eat what she wanted. It was when she went to the Jingzi Books and Cafe and served as a volunteer, and there was a child's family there which was a vegetarian influencing her.
When I went to Taipei to perform, the breakfast in the hotel was vegetarian. It was only me who eats meat. I thought it would be embarrassing to ask them to change.
She was the only child as her parents waited a long time for her.
After adopting this pet, she began to think that this is a very important playmate in her life. She always tells me that little hamster is her brother.
Respecting life helps suppress her appetite for meat. Cooking vegetables with her family also changed her bad habits.
I wonder why there was a pumpkin skin left over, so I asked her why since she didn't eat pumpkin, but she said that at school they couldn't be picky and had to finish everything.
The benefits of vegetarianism have also rewarded her as her physical strength has dramatically improved.
When I eat meat, I just run for a while and I'll be exhausted. After becoming a vegetarian, I feel that I have better endurance.
Her determination to eat vegetables is like her determination to learn the Chinese zither, as she is now a talented musician who is able to play pleasing music for everyone.
Many people think that it is not good to eat mangoes or bananas with black spots, indicating mold or the fruit being too ripe. Let's ask an expert about what causes these spots and if it is safe to eat them.
The hot summer is a season to eat mango, and the sweet taste attracts many people bite by bite. On the internet, some say that eating mangoes with black spots will affect our health. Is this true?
These black spots on mango skin may indicate infection with anthracnose disease or black spot disease. These are the two common diseases affecting mangoes. If the spot is small, just peel the skin as it is safe to eat.
If the dark spots penetrate the fruit and cause it to rot, it may not be suitable for consumption. The skin of a banana will also have dark spots. In fact, when the banana has sesame-like dark spots, it may be at its most nutritious and delicious stage.
When the banana has more black spots covering even more area and it's already soft, we don't recommend eating it.
Though mangoes and bananas are delicious, people with diabetes may want to exercise more restraint when consuming them.
Take about 2 servings a day. For mango, after dicing, 1 serving is about 70 to 80% of a 300 milliliter standard bowl. As for bananas, about half of the size of 1 plantain is 1 serving.
Mastering the principles of fruit selection and consumption can allow everyone the chance to enjoy the sweet taste with peace of mind.
In Yilan County, Taiwan, National Touchen Commercial Vocational High School arranged a trip for their students to experience recycling firsthand. They hope that the students can bring back what they learned and practice recycling at home.
The students remain silent when the volunteers ask questions about recycling. Therefore, the volunteers led them to do hands-on recycling to better understand which items are recyclable.
We learn about which items are recyclable and which are not. We also learn how to differentiate tin and aluminum cans. Recycling is really hard work. It really is.
This is Tocheng Vocational High School's moral lesson. The military teacher planned a visit to Tzu Chi's recycling station to better understand recycling and also learn about Tzu Chi's humanitarian missions.
Our theme is moral teaching. The students' conduct is most important, so we hope that through this activity we can improve our students' conduct.
To really practice recycling, besides sorting recyclables, volunteers also promoted vegetarianism, hoping that everyone can adopt a vegetarian diet, enabling all beings to live in harmony in this world.
In Kaohsiung, students from Zhongshan Senior High School created a reading area with antique objects. Through the process, they've realized the value of discarded materials. We'll leave you with these images. Thank you for joining us. Goodbye.